Hello everyone, welcome to another video. In this video we are going to solve the problem number inversions which was given in the problem of the day. So let's get started. The problem number inversions states that Rahul is facing a unique problem which he doesn't know how to solve. The problem asks him to build the smallest possible number by applying inversion on any digit of the number any number of times. Okay, let's see what an inversion means. Inversion of a digit is defined as a digit being replaced by 9 minus the digit, meaning that inversion of 9 will be 0, okay, and 1 will be 9 minus 8. So the final output should not have any leading zeros, okay. Alright, we have a number n, one second, integer, number can be up to 10 power 18, okay. Alright. To me it looks pretty straightforward. So the problem is basically we are given a number and we have to minimize the number. The way to minimize that number would be you can replace any digit with 9 minus the digit. So let's take the sample which is 87, right? So 87, we have for 8 we can do 9 minus 8 which is equal to 1, for 7 we can do 9 minus 7 which is equal to 2, and I think that's the smallest number. Let's go for 99. For 99, for the first 9 at the 10th place, we can do 9 minus 9, but we cannot do this because it will lead to leading zeros. So we leave it as it is. For the next 9, obviously, the best would be to reduce 9 from it, and so the answer would be 90. So the algorithm here would be to reduce, like to subtract the digit from 9 only if the resultant digit that comes after subtraction is smaller than the current digit. And the only condition we need to be sure about is there should be no zero on the first index. So let's get started into the code. All right. So they say that we're going to get a number. So I'm just going to take input. Okay. And number list of number is equal to character for character in str of, or we can directly do n, and let's just make it str, right? Makes sense. So the reason why I'm putting the number into a list is because strings are immutable by default. What immutability means is suppose I have a string named Shubham, I cannot directly do, suppose I have something like this, str is equal to this, I cannot directly do st, okay, str is a reserved keyword, I'll do a string of 0 is equal to a. No, this will not work. Strings are immutable. So that's why I'm changing it to list, because lists are mutable. Right, so let's go. So now I have to loop over this number, right? So I have to change the index. So I'll loop keeping the index at my disposal. So how do I do that? I'll do for I in range length of number. Okay. What is the possible modification we can do? So possible digit equal to 9 minus int of number, int of the current digit, right? This is the possible modification we can do. So if the current possible digit is less than the current digit, which is int of number of I, rather we can do one thing, since this is being repeated, always avoid repetition, DRY, do not repeat yourself, write dry code. So digit is equal to int of number of I, right? So we can directly do then for 9 minus digit, if possible digit is less than the current digit, we need to check if I is equal to z. So if possible digit is less than digit, we can do number of I is equal to possible digit. It will work, but what about 99? It'll go into this loop for the first 9. It will take digit is equal to 9, possible digit is equal to 0. So 0 is less than 9, so it will change it. But we have to take care about the first index. So if I is 0 and possible digit is also 0, then don't do anything. So I say continue. Right. So if the first index is, if you are on the first index and possible digit is coming as 0, please don't do anything, continue with the loop, otherwise change the number, right? And then we print a number, a list as a string. So join number, right? Should work. Let's see. Python 3 code.py says invalid. Okay, sorry guys, C++ mistake here. And okay, 99, we are getting str instance int found. Okay, while doing appending the number into the list, obviously only strings can be joined with strings, so we have to convert it to string because the list is made of strings. Str of possible digit. Okay, we should be good to go. Okay, for 89 we get 10, for 87 we get 12. And that's all about this problem. So hope you guys enjoyed this. The basic idea for this problem was, you know, you could just come up with test cases to see what the solution can be. Always when you are trying to code some problem or anything, try to read the problem, try to come up with the logic, and then try to find out test cases on your own before directly running it on the server, because there are contests on Code Forces or Code Chef where you just run it for the first time and you get a penalty if that is incorrect, and next time you'll not get the same point. So that's why always try to devise an algorithm, try to find counter test cases, and then try to solve the problem. All right, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks, and see you guys again in the next one. Bye.